welfare. You say get rid of it completely.
So, get rid of federal welfare. Now,
right. Would you see any federal money go back to the states for the purpose of welfare?
No. The difference between the Republicans and the Democrats is the Democrats want the present system with some improvements. The Republicans want to take the money from the people in the states and then dole it back to the states as
right.
though they were children on an allowance.
That's
what
right.
I want to do is to get the federal government out of it completely so that the money doesn't even go to Washington in the first place. Then let each state decide what it wants to do about it, and I would bet if you did that, you would find that most states would get out of the welfare business entirely, and we would be back to where we were in the 1950s when the word welfare wasn't even used. You're 12 years younger than I am, so you may not remember that before the 1960s, we didn't even use the word welfare. We talked about charity occasionally, and there were service clubs and churches that took care of indigent people, but the idea of a permanent welfare class didn't exist, and so we never even discussed welfare. It was when the federal government moved in the 1960s that welfare became a national scandal. So the first step is to get the federal government completely out of it.
All right. Well, let me be a teary-eyed liberal and come at you with their normal attack, and that is, but Harry, what about the children? There will be photographs and pictures on the nightly news of children starving, emaciated, flies buzzing around their little heads because you abolished welfare.
I accept the responsibility. First of all, I want to put the money back in the hands of the American people so that they can be generous as they want to be. And those people who are concerned about the welfare mothers and concerned about people who continue to have children can take care of them because they'll have the money. It will no longer be bled from them by the federal government. But secondly, even if it were true that there would be welfare mothers who would never be taken care of by anybody and children who might go hungry, we can no longer allow those people to hold the rest of the country hostage. That's what has happened. This fear of somebody going hungry has caused thousands of people to go hungry because they are not able to keep the money that they earn. It's being taken from them by Washington. And as a matter of fact, the tax load today is 47% of the national income. That is federal, state, and local taxes of one kind or another. Half of everything we earn is going to one government or another because of this fear that if we don't let the government take care of all these things, somebody someplace is going to starve.
Well, but it might happen. In other words,
of course it might happen.
I don't think Harry Brown or Art Bell give two hoots about the great big welfare queen who has her favorite place on the couch. The trouble is she has three innocent children. Now, after you've cut her off, you've got a 2-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 5-year-old, let's say. What happens to those children?
Back in the 1950s, we had situations like you talk about, except that they were very, very rare. But when they happened, churches took care of people, mm-hmm. service clubs took care of them. There were homes for mothers who did not have husbands but had children. There were all kinds of things available. But when the federal government moves in, the first thing it does is bankrupt everybody. And then it says, you can't take care of this, only if the government does it. But where does the government get the money in the first place? That money is being taken from us. And if it's given back to us, then we can decide for ourselves who is needy and who isn't.
This evening's guest, Harry Brown, is remarkably sensible on many issues, but each area requires massive change and reform, as Mr. Brown must know. With every major change, an adjustment period is needed. Specifically, what transitions do you see as being the most difficult, and what would you do to ease the pain of the transition? I mean, these are big changes you're talking about.
Of course they are, but the fact of the matter is if you ask the government to undertake a program of transition to phase out some federal function over a period of time, you are signing the death knell of freedom. What you are saying is the government is never going to get out because government does not extricate itself easily from things. And any government program to ease the transition for people off of welfare or from federal education to no federal aid to education and so on is just a government program. And a government program is not going to work any better than the government program we're trying to get rid of. So the only thing to do is to get the government out of it. But the thing that is lacking when the Republicans talk about cutting is that they are not putting any money in the hands of the American people to be able to take care of this transition themselves. That's the important part of it.
So you do it with a sharp knife.
Yes, but make sure that the money is there in the hands of the American people so that they can weather any adjustments that take place.